Please join me in giving a very warm welcome to Neil deGrasse Tyson.
I was 9, and it was my first visit to my local planetarium. You know, it's a big, cozy chair, and the lights dim, and it's an odd room with a round ceiling, right? Hemispherical ceiling, so I didn't quite know what to expect. Stars came out, and I thought it was a hoax, because I was born in the Bronx. I know how many stars there are in the night sky. There's about 11, right? I would later learn, of course, they're showing me the real sky, and the real sky, of course, is stunning. It's mind-blowing. And the act of embracing that real sky leaves me to reflect on that moment, not as me choosing to become an astrophysicist, but it was the universe choosing me. 2 years later, I said, oh, this is called being an astrophysicist. And there are people who have jobs to do this. That's what I want to be when I grew up. So I had that answer for the annoying adults that ask the kids, what do you want to be when you grow up? I would say, an astrophysicist. That usually shut them up pretty quickly. Because usually it's, oh, you want to be a lawyer? Oh, I know a lawyer. And it's like nobody knew any astrophysicists.
We, my planetary brethren, were discovering other objects in orbit around the sun, around where Pluto is orbiting the sun. And these objects were kind of icy, like Pluto, and kind of tipped orbit, cockamamie orbit, like Pluto. They had peculiar features all in common with Pluto. And so we took Pluto and said, let's not think of it as a ninth planet. Let's think of it as another one of these new family of objects just discovered in the outer solar system, known as the Kuiper Belt of Comets. So we did this. We did this. Well, I became public enemy, and I have a file cabinet drawer worth of hate mail from third graders. And everybody was having fun with this, including comics, a comedian, you know, cartoon illustrators. This one is simultaneously hilarious and a little bit sad. And look at these shoes, you know, it's got like those old man shoes, you know. And that face. Are there any Pluto lovers out here? Just so I know, who is still distraught? No, just raise your hand. Let me just see how many. Okay, there are 5 of you. Okay. So we're winning this one, everyone else. So just so you know, the solar system has 6 moons bigger than Pluto. Nobody told you that, did they? Oh, Pluto lovers out there. Pluto is more than half made of ice. So that if you brought Pluto to where Earth is right now, at this distance from the sun, the heat from the sun would evaporate the ice and it would grow a tail. That's no kind of behavior for a planet. Planets don't have tails. If you're made of ice and you got a tail, we've got a word for you. We call you a comet. So Pluto is just an awesome-sized comet. So we reclassified it with the other icy bodies in the outer solar system. And I think it's happier there, really, because it's with family. Plus, it's one of the biggest icy bodies in the outer solar system. Oh, by the way, I learned that if you're speaking to kindergarten children, you can't refer to icy bodies in the outer solar system because they think they're actual dead bodies. You know, I talked about icy bodies, and all the children were like, huh? It's like, what's the matter? So let me just confirm, Pluto is still not a planet, okay? And just get over it, all right? That's all. Just saying. We got to call it a night here. Thank you for your patience here.
Please give it, Dr. Tyson. On behalf of all of us from Kent State, thank you.
Thank you.